Welcome, welcome dear student. In one another session, myself Darshana Sandeep Shinde from KK Wagh Institute of Pharmacy Chanduri, Nashik. Our today's discussion topic is salicylate used as an analgesic and antipyretic. Let's start our session. In this session, we cover the point learning outcome of our session. Students should be able to understand antipyretic anti-inflammatory drug, then what absorption, fate, excretion of salicylates, pharmacological action of salicylate, and adverse reaction of salicylates. Let's see one by one. First of all, see what is meant by NSAIDs. The agent also have the antipyretic and anti-inflammatory properties, therefore named as analgesic antipyretics. These are also called as a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Antipyretics means these are the agents which reduce the elevated body temperature. And anti-inflammatory drugs, these are the agents which used to produce the sympathetic relief from the inflammation. First of all, we see what is meant by inflammation. It is in fact a process involving a series of events that initiated by the stimulus. A stimulus may be injury to the tissue, infection by microorganism, or certain mediators released by antigen-antibody reactions. Then, these responses to the stimulus are described as anti-inflammatory responses, and it considered as a clinical signs such as the localized edema, paining, and sometimes fever. Edema is the stagnation of the tissue fluid that results from the vasodilation and diffusion or the plasma water. The synthesis and release of the prostaglandin and cytokines are associated with the paining and fever. With the classification of analgesic antipyretic, the major analgesic antipyretic are classified into following groups. First one is salicylates, example of it, aspirin, sodium salicylate. Second class is the para-aminophenol derivatives, example of it, paracetamol, phenacetine. Third class is pyrazone derivative, example of it, phenylbutazone, oxyphenbutazone. Then fourth class is the indole acetic acid derivatives, example of it, indomethacin. Then anthranilic acid derivatives, example of it, mefenamic acid. And last and sixth class is the propionic acid derivatives, example of it, ibuprofen and naproxen. First of all, see what is meant by salicylates. Salicylates are most popular and effective analgesic agents. Acetic salicylic acid is the most widely used among the salicylates. We see the fate, absorption and excretion of the salicylates. Salicylates are favor the gastric pH absorption. Then these are always given on food to prevent the gastric irritation. Because of the salicylates, if you given it or empty stomach, it responsible or it can have the irritation in the stomach, which may lead to the nausea and vomiting. Another way of preventing the gastric irritation by sodium salicylate is to given sodium bicarbonate with the salicylate. Then excretion of the salicylate in the urine is a pH dependent, and increase in the pH of the urine increases. The elimination of aspirin as a salicylic acid in the urine. The next one is the salicylates are well absorbed from the stomach and small intestine, because the salicylates are the weak acids. That's why these are well absorbed from the stomach. This is the fate, absorption and excretion of the salicylates. Then we see the pharmacological action of the salicylates. Pharmacological activity of aspirin is dose dependent. Then at a normal therapeutic dose, it has analgesic, antipyretic and anti-inflammatory properties, while at a higher dose, it has a uricosuric effect. Uricosuric means these are the agents which are responsible to remove the uric acids, excretion of the uric acids. Then third one is, it has both peripheral and central system effects. The fourth one is the mechanism of action include the inhibition of the enzyme like the cyclooxygenase, prostaglandin synthetase, and these salicylates have the following effects. Let's see one by one. The first effect of a salicylate is an analgesic action. Salicylate produce a relief of pain without producing a marked impairment of the mental activity. They are mainly used for the relieving dull aching pain of the low intensity coming from the structures such as the muscles and the joints. It is supposed to act a hypothalamus, which is responsible for the integration of pain sensation. By peripheral action, salicylate block the effect of the bradykinin on the pain-producing chemoreceptors. Salicylate also reduce the prostaglandin synthesis and release. This is the analgesic action of, and these are useful for the toothache and dysmenorrhea. Dysmenorrhea is the medical term for pain with the menstruation. Then next action is the antipyretic action. In the fever, heat regulating center in the hypothalamus is affected. Then aspirin reset the mechanism of heat regulation to function the normal body temperature. Then it acts as the excess of a heat from the body is lost by peripheral vasodilation and perspiration. Perspiration means excretion of sweat from the sweat glands. This result in the lowering of the body temperature. After that, exact mechanism of antipyretic action is not known, but however, lower of the level of the prostaglandin like substance is increased in the brain, that's why antipyretic action takes place. Aspirin does not reduce the normal temperature. The next action is effect on respiration. First effect, salicylate stimulate the respiration. Then as a result of metabolic effect, salicylate increases the consumption of oxygen by skeletal muscles, result in the increased carbon dioxide production, which in turn result into the stimulation of the respiration. Then salicylate also stimulate the directly the medullary respiratory center. The fourth effect of the salicylates on the respiration is a hyperventilation result from the respiratory stimulation causes the respiratory alkalosis. The next effect is the anti-inflammatory and anti-rheumatic effect. Salicylate reduces the capillary permeability and diminishes the amount of the exudation. This action plays important part in their anti-rheumatic action. After that, by variety of the stimuli in the body, bradykinin and prostaglandin like substances are released, which lead inflammation. After that, aspirin and indomethacin are supposed to inhibit the release of these substances and cause the anti-inflammatory actions. Next effect is the uricosuric effect. The action of the salicylate on the uric acid excretion due on the dose of the salicylates. In a dose less than the 3 gram per day, they block the secretion of the uric acid and raise the blood uric acid level. However, when the daily increased up to the 5 gram or more, then it prevents the reabsorption of the uric acid and increase its excretion. Thus, in the large doses, it is a uricosuric, and small doses, it causes a retention of uric acid. Though, what is meant by uricosuric drugs? Uricosuric drugs are the substances that increases the excretion of the uric acid in the urine, thus reducing the concentration of uric acid in the blood plasma. Metabolic effect. In the metabolic effect, salicylate enhance the utilization of glucose by sugar level tissue, which leads to the lowering of the blood effect occur at the large doses, that is a hypoglycemic effect. Then salicylates are also effective in the dermatological disorders. Salicylates has a keratolytic effect and hence used in the treating the superficial fungal infection in the treatment of the corns. It also methyl salicylates is a rubefacient and it acts as a counter irritant. Keratolytic therapy is a treatment to remove the warts, calloses and other lesions in which the epidermis produce excess of the skin. Then what is meant by rubiaficient? Rubiaficient is a substance for the topical application that produces a redness of the skin and sometimes it have the inflammation also. Adverse effect of the salicylates, it includes the main adverse effect of salicylates is the hypoprothrombinemia, that is decrease the prothrombin level in the blood, leading to increase the bleeding tendency. Then second one is the therapeutic dose of the salicylate used to analgesic antipyretic cause the irritation, nausea and vomiting. The third adverse effect is gastrointestinal bleeding is also a common one. The next one, allergic reaction may occur. Then it resemble of the toxicity produced by the quinine, that is synconism. The symptoms disappear when the discontinuation of the drug dosage. Acute toxicity of the salicylate may cause the hypertension. And last one is the chronic administration of the salicylate may cause the toxic manifestation known as the salicylism. The symptoms of the salicylism include the nausea, vomiting, headache, tinnitus. Tinnitus means ringing in the ears, deafness, dizziness, restlessness and mental confusion. These are the adverse effects associated with the salicylates. Then summary, in this session we cover the point antipyretic and anti-inflammatory drugs, then classification of antipyretic and anti-inflammatory drug, absorption, fate, excretion of salicylates, pharmacological action of the salicylates and adverse reaction of the salicylates. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any queries, this is my mail ID, contact me.